Okay, everybody. Top of the afternoon. It's Friday, 12 noon. You know what time it is. It's time for the Entrepreneurial Web. I'm your host, Jeremiah Fox. Special show today. It's kind of a milestone for me. I've been doing the show for nearly a year at this point, and I finally felt comfortable to the point where I could bring some guests on that had been on before. We'll hear from Sam Himmelstein at 12:30. He was one of my first guests ever on the show when we were in studio, but my first guest today is also a returning guest, Damon Johnson. He's a real estate executive out of Detroit, Michigan. He's also just a social media like icon. The guy's amazing in his interaction with people. He's always been an inspiration for me, always a source of happiness. We'll talk about that in a minute. He was one of my first guests once we went virtual, which was in at the end of March, when we could no longer broadcast in the studio, and I was forced to get out of my comfort zone a little bit and do some Zoom calls and some outreach, and it turned out to be one of the best things. So before we bring him on, I usually do a message of the week. This week, I'm going to quote a statistic because this show is all about housing, the housing market, and this is kind of profound. I just read again this morning that there are over 67,000 available rentals and apartments and houses in New York City right now, which is kind of unprecedented. With that, we're going to discuss with Damon Johnson. Damon, how are you today, sir?
Hey, how are you?
Great. Good to see you, my man. How's everything?
You too. Everything is going great. I just left from one meeting. Now I'm on this one.
And you're going to another one afterwards, I'm assuming.
No, I'm going to work, actually. And then I think I'm done with meetings for the day, I think.
Yeah, we'll see. You're a hustler. I sense something in your future coming down the pipe soon.
Yes.
How are things going in Detroit these days? We haven't spoken about the situation in a while.
Goodness gracious. I'm as busy as I've ever been. It's been unprecedented. You know, we're really an automotive state. GM, Ford, and Chrysler, our headquarters are all three here. They're all within 15 miles of each other. We're home to two powerhouse national mortgage companies. So it's business here has been absolutely great and kind of sad at the same time too, yeah. Because a lot of people, yeah, you know, of course, aren't working or had to downsize or taking pay cuts. So it's like feast and famine at the same time.
Same here. I'd say the same is true in New York. And Sam will elaborate that a little later on the show, because he's on the other side of the spectrum where he's dealing with people. You know, he's a tenant lawyer, so he's representing a lot of people who have lost income and you know, now they're I'm not sure if they extended it, but the initial moratorium on evictions was due to expire mid-August, and we're past that. They may have granted an extension. He'll know more about that. They did there. I think they did here too. There was definitely talk of it, but that can't last forever.
No.
You know. Just out of curiosity, how does the automotive headquarters affect housing in your area?
Just because GM, Ford, and Chrysler, their headquarters are all here. And the spinoff from them for the parts plants, the tech, the transportation, the actual computer IT end of it, the tires, the doors, the whatever that goes into making the cars, a lot of those plants are here, which means a lot of people work there and want to live by where they work. It affects the downtowns because GM is downtown Detroit.
Okay.
Chrysler is in Auburn Hills, Pontiac, and Ford is in Dearborn. And Ford, actually, you know, the city of Dearborn really is all Ford because they have Henry Ford Hospital, the museums. It's really like a thing
with Ford.
Right, with Ford. So the way that the automotive companies go here is the way that our economy goes. And right now, they are back to work. I don't know if they're back like 100%, but they're everybody that I know that works in the offices and the actual plant part of it, they're all back to work. But cautiously, of course,
yeah.
People are still buying cars and our demand is still up for housing. We don't have the inventory to meet the demand right now.
Not at all. It's interesting because where I'm at in Brooklyn is largely residential. You know, Brooklyn has a small downtown area, but nothing in comparison to Manhattan. And Brooklyn is pretty solid. And the businesses, most of the businesses are back open. There's, gyms can't reopen and a few things like that. But for the most part, the wheels are kind of turning in a lot of spots. And in Brooklyn, it's very similar where there's not enough inventory to meet demand because so many people, especially people before who were like, oh, no, I'm not living in Brooklyn. Now they're like, Brooklyn look really good right now. You know, right? You got a little 12-foot backyard and you're like upbidding on it, you know, all of a sudden leaving your Manhattan high rise.
Right.
So that's happening here. But then you take Manhattan and I've heard Queens as well are both there's just so many vacancies and a lot of it has to do with, you know, companies are just not going back there. You know, there's not so much manufacturing, but a lot of, you know, advertising and finance and everything. And they're just, a lot of them have called it. They're working remotely either through the rest of the year, or some have said until there's a vaccine, they're not going back in, and who knows how long that is. So people are, they're kind of scattering about. And I think when they make a final decision about schools or whatever, respond to anything that happens next month, that'll be very telling too, because if you also don't have to be present for your kid,
right?
To like, see, all bets are off.
We're all virtual here for the main 90% virtual for elementary, middle, and junior high. Colleges have went, I think they're doing half and half. Like, if you want to go, you can go. So that client for me is still, you know, in place. People are still buying and selling. I'm more worried about, well, not sense of worry, cautious about if you sell your home now, I don't have anywhere to put you. Or you have to wait, or you have to be ready to really bid. My buyers now, you have to be above ask. There are no more deals. That's over with for a while. We're doing appraisal guarantees here, and we're doing like escalation clauses, like where if you bid $200,000, we'll bid 201. It's like whatever bid that you get as a final and best, the agents now are saying, oh, I'll give you more.
Right.
Which is kind of a slippery slope because with the appraisal guarantees, you don't know what the home is going to appraise for. And then the bank isn't giving you that money. That comes out of your actual pocket. So it's like, be very mindful when you want to do that. So I've been getting by without them. I've only had to do one, and we got our bid on that one anyway. So we were 20 grand over. And we still got our bid. So I was like, well, this one wasn't, you know, meant to be. So
yeah. I mean, I've heard of that happening with rentals in Brooklyn.
Oh, I'm sure.
Crazy. Isn't that?
I'm sure.
A lot of people are entering the market cautiously, it seems like, because they're not sure what's gonna happen. So they're not looking to necessarily buy something else right now and get locked into another place they don't wanna be. They're looking for short-term rentals. And even, you know, municipalities are kind of encouraging that as well, like considering like some 3-month and 6-month leases for vacancies, because people are, you know, here it's a lot more transient. I can imagine where you're at, people kind of, they don't move too far, probably.
Yeah, they don't move. It's usually don't move too far. It's like maybe you move to another city or another neighborhood, but you aren't like, once you, it's not so transient, because everything here, you can get to in a half hour. You can be from Detroit to the burbs in a half hour, tops.
Right. What are some of the deals that were happening before you mentioned that and that are not happening now? I mean, you spoke about one, and on social media mentioned some other stuff like extensions and what's happening.
We've been,
it's kind of crazy
doing
right now.
Where a lot of the deals are taking longer than what they used to take. I used to be at a 15-day. I used to be able to close within 15 days, 10 on some deals. Now we're 30, 45 days.
Really?
They're wanting to see more of your bank statements. They're wanting to, you know, not drag out the process, but make sure that you're financially ready.
Right.
Which before, we didn't have to. We just assumed that once you got your pre-approval, you were good to go.
Yeah.
Whereas now they're doing a lot more upfront with the deal. I haven't, knock on wood, lost any deals because of it. I've been blessed to work with, you know, a great group of clients and referrals, and social, of course, has been awesome for me.
Yeah.
Whereas now I'm more cautious. with going to show, like I don't show just to show now.
Right.
I don't like, you just can't call me and say, hey, let's go see 10 houses today. I'm like, no.
Not
Let's look at
happening.
these 10 online first and make sure we narrow this list down because we are going into homes and I'm being cautious, but at the same time, I don't want to just entertain you because you're bored at home and you want to look up some houses.
Right.
That's not, being safe for you, me, anyone involved. It's just, I'm being a lot more cautious now. A lot of people, I'm sorry, go
That's
ahead.
better for that's better for the industry too, isn't
Yes.
it? It's been, I mean, it's much more productive for the industry and for everybody, whether, and like everybody loves to be entertained, but sometimes that can, it can go too far and it becomes very counterproductive.
Yes, just because, and I think the people here have gotten the message that there are no deals. Not just saying any deals, it's just as everybody who has the money to buy now, because rates are so low, they're buying now,
Right.
they're refinancing now, they're renting office space now because you can get the free rent. They're doing free rent on a lot of popular cities here for office space for the rest of the year. And you get like a discounted rate for the next 2 or 3
They want,
years.
they need them leases, man. They
Oh,
need
I
them
know.
commercial leases.
Those commercial leases, if you want to open up whatever you want to open up now is the time
Yeah.
to get the space in the prime locations just because. And the rentals, our rental market for residential here, to me, you might as well buy the house
Right.
and then rent it because you're going through the same process. They want you to have the 3 months to show 3 months of income. You only got to show 1 month or 2 months of income to get the house. So it's like, I always tell my clients, get the house. If you had to sell it in a couple of years, it's better that you had it to sell or refi, because if you walk into a bank and say, hey, I want a personal loan for 50 grand, they're going to be like, bye. But if you refi your home that you own, they'll be like, oh, great.
Right.
Here you go. So I tell people, if you're in a position to buy, great. If you're in a position where you want to hold on to your house and you don't want to sell, great. So I've been having that conversation with my clients as well. If they're iffy, I always say, hold on to it. Let's wait and see what the spring, has in store. Let's wait till after the election, after the holidays,
Right.
whatever you want to do. The group of clients I'm working with now, everything is going great. So my next group will be my end of the year, end of the last quarter group. So that group is always very interesting. It's not, it's there, it's usually a lot more serious buyers. So we'll see. But new construction is still hot here, which amazes me. So
Yeah,
it's like,
same here. The build outs are going, they're just slapping them up. I'm like,
yeah,
okay.
I'm like, so who's moving here? There are condos now being built for my office, and we're like, who?
You're gonna fill them. I know you. You're gonna
Oh
fill them.
yeah,
You're gonna be out there.
I'm gonna at least, my goal is to do 30 more deals from now to the end of the year. So
Love it. Love
I
it.
got 4 out of 5 going on now. So if I just work a little harder,
You gotta tell them, finish that building, man. We gotta get I
hurry,
got
I have a
goals.
client, I have a buyer for sure.
That's great. All right, we're gonna take a quick break. We'll be back in just a minute, okay? Hang
Awesome.
tight. We'll be back in just in a minute, folks. All right, everybody, we're back again, the entrepreneurial web. I'm your host, Jeremiah Fox. We're checking in with Damon Johnson. He's a real estate executive in Detroit. He called the market earlier this week wild. How wild is it?
It's like the wild,
You're
wild
wild.
west. It's right. This is wild. This I've never seen anything like this. Never.
Yeah. And you've been at it for about 10 plus years, right?
I don't know. There's no predicting this. There,
Yeah.
I'm as busy as I've ever been, and I'm answering questions that I've never had to answer before.
Yeah, sure. Same here, for sure. You said something in the last segment about the end of the year and how that's always really interesting. And I think it's going to be like the most interesting because we still have to wait and see with states making decisions about schools, about restaurants, about indoor activities, the fear of a resurgence of coronavirus. What that, I mean, the roadmap for human behavior is just like out the window right now, you know, just like, phew, it's, all right, let's just, we all have blinders on. I'm curious, I'm really curious to see how that plays out for, for more stable markets like yours, but especially here, like, is it gonna create a further exodus? Are people gonna say, you know, like the rents are down here big time. I think the article that I read that was saying there's 67,000 vacancies right now.
Wow.
The average rent in Manhattan is down to about $3,000, which is like laughable. You know what I'm saying? It's like, I was like to my wife, like, we might move to the city.
It is so funny because $3,000 a month here could get you a palace.
Right, right. Here it's like a studio, but not now people are, you know, now you're starting to see like, you know, 1200 square foot, two bedrooms in the East Village for $3,000, you know, which has never happened before. But you know, what's going to happen is as soon as everything cools down, it's going to swing back up and even higher than before. And anybody returning, it's going to be a tax. There's going to be a return tax. Like the toll you got to pay. Like, I know your apartment was $5,000 before, but
now it's 10.
Man,
and there's a wait list.
Yeah, exactly. And man, if I had the bread, I would be scooping up those little condos left and right. Right,
and that's what people are doing. I follow I have a few friends who are realtors in New York, and they're like, Damon, people are buying like crazy, just sitting on them. I was like,
I'd buy like 10 right now if I could, and just like
why not? Because people have to live somewhere, and people have to eat, and people have to live. So,
not bad.
Here we are.
Industries.
Here we are. I tell my clients, you know, if you can afford to buy an investment home now, or a condo, or an apartment to rent out, now's the time, because people have to live somewhere. You may not get the $5,000 there a month. For I still, your prices are so crazy to me here. You may not get that, but I mean, some form of you know, path of income is better than your day job, which may go away.
Yeah.
Like my day job went away for a minute when they shut real estate down.
Yeah.
Thank goodness I had some hustle income from social media, helping people with their social media. Like, oh, this is a real job for me now, because
you had me fooled. I thought it was a real job all along.
Oh, I know everybody does. They're like, I didn't know you did real estate.
Man.
I was like,
kill it. You kill it.
I was like, no, I really do real estate full time in social media. It's supposed to be part time, but yeah, we'll see how that goes. The market is just, I tell people, don't buy anything that's going to depreciate right now. No new cars. No, I see people buying cars and motorcycles and going to Jamaica, and I'm like, listen, you have $10,000, hold on to it.
Right, exactly.
This may be your rent money, your grocery money, your whatever.
Or investment. Hold on to that.
If you're going to buy the house, buy the house. If you're going to rent the apartment, rent the apartment. But nothing that you can't lay your head on, or nothing that's not going to, you know, sustain you for the winter months. Because here, well, there you guys get snow too. We get blizzards here.
Oh, I know.
I
lived in Buffalo. I know what happens.
Oh,
there.
I have family in Buffalo, so yeah, you get the gist of it. Mm-mm. So the end of the year here used to be determined by school. We had Labor Day was kind of hurry up and sell or buy by Labor Day, because people wanted to switch schools or stay there. But now, with school being for the most part virtual, our purchase season has gotten extended here. But now we're worried about, because we have such a hot summer. Usually in Michigan, we have a hot summer. The winter is usually terrible. Last one for us was terrible. So it's like, I'm just going to go until the blizzards get here. Usually we're not done. Usually we're done with the buying and selling after Thanksgiving, before Christmas. But this year, I don't know. I'm assuming we're going to be busy because kids are at home. It doesn't matter what school district you're in now, because you're home. So
I think it's going to really throw the behaviors for a loop because of that, you know, because a lot of people.
I'm sorry. Go ahead.
I was just say a lot of people buy in certain areas because of the schools.
Right.
And if Billy doesn't have to go to school, you know, if it's just going to be remote, you have a lot more options that way. And it's going to affect, you know, what people think about going forward. And who knows when that situation is going to settle down with schools. I mean, here they can't really make a decision on anything. And
see, they made our decision here. They were, for the most part, virtual.
Yeah.
So, and I have that shirt. My hoodie came the other day.
I was gonna ask. I was gonna ask if you noticed.
Of course. You come on now. You know that's
my guy. I just got mine. You didn't mention it yet, so I was just waiting.
No, you know that. when you first came, and it was so funny when it came, I reached out to him and I was like, I need another one because I was expecting good quality. I wasn't expecting great quality.
Yeah.
When
No,
I,
the shirt feels great.
oh,
So good.
my own merch that I have on doesn't feel like
Right,
that. And I was
right.
like, oh. It was just, and the details on that hoodie, I was like,
I haven't tried the hoodie on yet. I literally just got
oh.
it. This I just pulled this out of the package today
Mine was
and,
yes,
threw it
mine
on.
was, what's today, Friday? Mine was Wednesday?
Yeah.
Wednesday. It was on my doorstep Wednesday, and I was so
Yeah.
amazed. Just
Did you
that
expect any
happiness.
less? Did you expect any less?
I don't know what I was expecting. It was just so made for me. I was like, oh, I'm not, you know how I am with the stuff. I need one to wear and one just to look at in
Right.
my Vayner umbrella closet that I just keep like the stalker that I am. I was
Right.
like, I just need one to look at and one to maybe
I
wear.
hear you. I hear you. Mine's
Yeah.
gonna get, I'm gonna wear it to work tonight and it's gonna get dirty and that'll be it. But
See, you're so brave.
I'll be happy. You ought to see my K-Swiss, man. They're a mess. I bought new
My.
ones though. They're in the box still and I just put them aside because mine just got wrecked. And I was at a certain point, I was like, you know what? If I'm gonna do it, I'm gonna do it in style.
I have three of each, and I never wear the ones that I have signed will
That's
never see the light of
crazy.
day. The other two are like, are you so no, yeah, but yeah, social. My thing that you mentioned, my videos, I have a new
Yeah.
guy.
It's obvious. They look
Yeah,
amazing, man.
and it's so funny. Shout out to my old guy, but my new guy, the Trip Audio Visual, he is, like amazeballs. He gets my crazy, and he gets it where he got it quick, where it's like he pushes me to do different things, and to my videos are backed up now. I have so much stuff to
Yeah.
put out that it's like, and he catches me off guard. The video I was walking downtown Detroit
I
was
saw
not a
that.
video. We were filming something else.
Yeah.
That wasn't a real video. That was me. We were done for the day. That was us going to get tacos for Whiskey Wednesday.
Whiskey wins. I see you stepped it up a little
Yeah.
bit.
So that was like an outtake. I didn't even know he was filming. I swear we were just walking across the street and people were like, damn, you didn't know that was going on. But because that's what he does for a
Yeah.
living. He it just has been it's been mind-boggling to me. I just look at it like, how are you going to top this? I'll
Yeah.
shoot him a crazy idea and he's like, well, what audience do you want? Do you see it more on Facebook? Do you see more on Insta? Do you see more on TikTok? Where do you see it more like on LinkedIn? Where do you see it? And we'll just go from there and he'll tailor it how I want, how he sees it. And I don't even have to go look at anything that he does. I just,
Right.
when he sends it to me, I'm like, boink, I just post it and then
It's
put some
fantastic.
context on there, and there we go. I'm in love. If you could ever be in love with your videographer, he's my D-Rock, and I just like I'm people, and it's so weird. People are like, who is doing your stuff? And I was like, he's such a nerd. It just
Yeah.
has been, it's been like awesome. I was at his house a couple of weeks ago when he did my Twitch show that I didn't know I was doing. I was there to film regular real estate videos, and he was like, oh, let me show you what I've been working on. And we were sitting there like, how did you do this?
Yeah.
And it just has been, yeah. And but you know, social now has taken just every time you think we figured it out, it's like, boink, here's something else.
Yeah.
But what's so weird about social lately, less and less people are posting, I'm posting more.
Exactly. I've noticed that.
Yeah,
I've
have you noticed
like
that?
I have. I've been like, I'm still grinding the same way I have. I've increased my friend. I was talking to my friend this morning. She's like, how much do you post a day? And I'm like, man, it's a
Yeah,
lot.
you're going crazy with it. I love it.
But I've noticed people that were like very, inspirational to me early on. I'm like, where? And I gotta check, like, are they just not in my feed anymore? And then I'll go to their
Yeah.
account and I'll be like, no, they literally haven't posted. And I'll send them a message like, hey, hope you're doing well and everything. But man, everybody responds to situations differently, and I think you and I have both gravitated towards, you know, certain more. Messages, much more. But more. We've heard certain messages over the years, and we've gravitated towards it. And so, like, I'm excited by what's happening right now. And I know a lot of people aren't. And I'm, you know, I know a lot of people have gotten the short end of the stick, but there's also plenty of people who could. They could just, you know, you just roll your sleeves up and that's it. I mean, I got no roadmap either. I just said.
Yeah, I'm figuring if it's a deal to be done, if it's a social media client who needs my help, I'm figuring do it now, but they can still pay me, or I can still help, or I can still help somebody, because I give out right. a lot.
Yeah, no,
I give
same.
Out so much free advice. I get so many questions a day about social and real estate. I'm like, yes, yes, no, yes, yes, no, no, no. So I feel like my rate is cheap when I do charge for social. I'm like, I don't try to gouge anybody. So, yeah. So with you and your restaurant and your ventures and you're working out, and I see it now, are the jiu-jitsu studios open back up or no?
No. They don't even have a timeline, man. Nothing.
Some of our gyms are open, which is crazy to me. And then some aren't. They're letting the cities dictate and the counties dictate which gyms are open. But I thought about that, and I said, I don't know if he's in the studio.
Yeah, no, I just in the basement of my building. We popped up some mats, and just a couple of us will get together. It's been the same people for months now, just working together, super small groups. But, you know, in New York State, they just announced, actually, a group of gym owners sued the governor, and he was like, oh, okay, you can open on the 24th. But then Mayor de Blasio here in New York said, forget about New York City. Like, the rest of the state, you can dine indoors already at limited capacity, not in New York City. He said gyms won't open before September for sure, and it's going to be modified by like martial arts schools and like grappling. That's going to be like it's going to be like Broadway and grappling come together like a group deal, you know. It's the opposite of social distancing. We want to close
Broadway
the distance.
Show. The grappling, bro.
Working on it, man. Broadway. I'm working on it. It's crazy.
Yeah, why not?
All right, we're going to have to hop on. I'm going to have to bring Sam on, but thank you so much for coming on again. So,
thank you for having me back on. We were really, my broker was like, you're going back on. I thought, yes, we're going back on.
No, we're
going
to do this again. I feel like Joe Rogan now, how he brings like his old friends and old guests back on. I'm like, we're getting somewhere. We're getting somewhere.
So I must have did something right to get a return call. I'm so appreciative for having me on. Thank you. Keep doing what you're doing. If you need me to do anything, you know, we always talk. So,
where can people find you? Let them know.
I am DJ Realty Solutions on all social media. My email is DamonJohnson100@gmail.com. Any questions, anything I can help you guys with social, real estate, make sure to reach out to me. I'm always available.
All right, brother. Be well. Great to talk to you again. We'll talk soon. We'll be back, everybody, in just a moment. Zooming back to New York City with Sam Himmelstein. Stay tuned.